Hi guys, welcome to another video. I haven't been making that many videos lately, and the main reason for that is that both the armies I play obviously got new codexes, and as a result, it takes some time to get used to new codexes, and I've been having success with them both, but until I really know the ins and outs of each codex, what units perform in what way properly, then I don't really want to be making tactical videos with advice on it because I'm only going to miss things or get things wrong. So, because of that, I'm kind of holding off, and I will make videos on them eventually. And obviously, when I do, then hopefully the information in them will be correct and helpful. So, with that in mind, I thought I'd make a different kind of video today, and it's based around a question that I see quite a lot. And that's basically how to start a Sisters of Battle army, or Adeptus Sororitas as they're now called. And you see this a lot on forums and that kind of thing. People go, I want to start a Sisters army, and they don't really know where to start or what they should be doing. And that's not that surprising, because if you think about it, there isn't that much information out there, especially from Games Workshop themselves. I mean, in the rule book you have, and this is in the big rule book, you have like 2 pages based on the background of Sisters of Battle, and then 2 more pages which simply show some of the miniatures, and that's pretty much all the information you get. Compared to the information you get for other armies, you know, there's not that much to go on, and it can also be hard to find the codex. I mean, until very recently, when the new codex came out, there wasn't actually a codex available at all for new players without piracy. So, because of that, I'm going to try and help steer people towards how to make a Sisters army. And to start with, I'm going to explain what you need to actually play Sisters and whether or not you actually should. And then I'm going to go on to the type of models you should aim to collect, that kind of thing, when building your first army. That's for this video. I'll make a second video later on which will actually explain the tactics you can use in building your army on units and that kind of thing to get an effective army off the ground. So let's start then. Obviously the first thing you need is the Codex. So the Codex now is available through Black Library. It's an ebook only. There is no printed version as yet. Rumours were that it actually sold very well. I know it was in the top 6 worldwide for iBooks or iTunes, sorry. So because of that, perhaps they'll bring it out in an actual print. But for now, the only way you can get it is as an ebook. Now you can get it on your iPad from iTunes, obviously. That comes with lots of interactive features, as usual with Games Workshop books, or you can get a version for your e-reader. Works as any other ebook basically, so that's EPUB format or MOBI format. Now, one of the issues people have with this is that they may not have a tablet or a smartphone or some way of actually reading the codex. But that doesn't really matter because so long as you have a computer, you can get free e-reading software, and the one I use is called Calibre. And basically, this means you can read it on your computer. And another factor that Calibre does for you is that it actually lets you convert the file into a PDF, and then once you have the PDF, you can fit it on more things, and of course, you can print it. And it's perfectly legal to print it in the Black Library conditions. You can have a printout for your own personal use. You can take it to Games Workshop stores. You can take it to tournaments, that kind of thing. So it's perfectly legitimate to use. So with that in mind, you can get your codex, and the good thing is it's actually slightly cheaper because it's digital format than the actual hardback codexes. So in that sense, you're making a little bit of a saving, tiny bit. It has all the usual kind of stuff in it. So there you go. Once you have the codex, well, even before you get the codex, really, if you look at the actual pictures and the brief bit of fluff you get in the 6th edition rulebook, and you like what you see, okay, try going on Lexicanum or Wikipedia for 40k, that kind of thing, and reading a bit more on Sisters of Battle or Adeptus Sororitas and the Ecclesiarchy and all that kind of thing. Look at a lot of the minis and that kind of thing. Watch some battle reports. The reason being is because if you don't like the fluff or the look at the minis or anything like that, then you're probably not going to enjoy playing Sisters of Battle. And as a result, I would advise you not to even start, because if you don't like it, basically Sisters are a big investment, and you need to be sure you're ready for it before you dive in. It's not like the other armies where you can collect a little bit here and there. Well, I'll go into that a bit more later, but that's something to bear in mind. So make sure you actually like that. And once you get the codex, read the fluff. If you still like it, you know, brilliant. If the idea of it doesn't, you don't really enjoy it, or you're not really feeling the army, that kind of thing, you know, then probably best to quit while you're ahead, you know. Sisters of Battle are incredibly expensive. Basically, they're probably one of the most, if not the most, expensive army to collect in 40k, and that includes Forge World. Yeah, it's about nearly £55 for a single squad of 10. And that's just normal troops choices. So you can see it's going to get very expensive very quickly. So bear that in mind, basically. If you enjoy it, though, go for it. You'll have a lot of fun. You just have to be sensible about it. Okay, so say you got the codex. You've read about them. You like the background. You like the look. You like the aesthetic, that kind of thing. Okay, the next important thing is basically the rules. Now, obviously, you have the rules in front of you, but in case you're not sure about 40k or it's your first 40k army, that kind of thing, I should really describe the Sisters' playstyle. Sisters of Battle tend to be a very strange niche, and it's shifted somewhat with the new codex. Previously, their niche was actually extreme close range, get in close, fairly slow, but get in close, overwhelm the opponent, have a few tricks to fall on, and basically finish them off with a powerful assault. Now, you could fall heavily on one side or the other, so you could have a very powerful assault with less shooting, or you could have a very powerful shooting with less powerful assault, but generally that was the kind of thing that you'd go for. Because of that, it meant you had to get in close, and the biggest weakness was range and like high strength single shot kind of things, you know, like missile launches, las cannons, that kind of thing. Don't have anything like that. Okay, so because of that, I should say that hasn't changed that much. However, Sisters, the specialist assault units have got slightly worse. Okay, so they're not as powerful in the assault, but the short range shooting units, that is your troops and everything else, have got much better in assault. So in other words, they can do it more themselves. And what this means is that they'll now be the ones doing the shooting and then doing the charging or being charged in return, and they'll be able to take it themselves. And so Sisters of Battle have kind of moved away from a more specialist army, kind of closer to Eldar in some ways, into a more versatile army which can deal with everything themselves. However, they're still weaker than other armies out there on an individual basis. So if that sounds like something you'd like, then you're on the right track. The other thing that Sisters of Battle do really well is trickery. Now, there's lots of armies out there who have many tricks in their list, like hidden surprises they can pull out, that kind of thing. Sisters of Battle are surprising because, first of all, barely anyone ever plays them. So they're very rare to face on the tabletop. And because of that, people don't know their basic moves as well. They don't really know what they're capable of. On top of that, they have Acts of Faith, which give them some sort of bonus special rules, that kind of thing. And on top of that, you can supply them with enough kind of war gear or attach extra models such as priests, that kind of thing, to really make them even more flexible, more powerful, and have a lot more nasty surprises in the unit. So with that in mind, you know, you can really surprise your opponents, especially if it's their first time playing against Sisters, which a lot of the time it will be. Even if they if they're used to playing against Sisters of Battle, you can still pull out some surprises. So if you can imagine Space Marines, but then being able to do very unexpected things and lacking some of the versatility in units, but kind of having more on the individual troops' choices, that kind of thing, then that is pretty much how Sisters of Battle play. They're not that fast moving. There are ways to compensate for that, but, you know, not that fast moving. They're not very good at long range, but again, there's ways to compensate for that if you build for it. And generally, people would say they're not very good in assault, although they're a lot better in assault than those other things I've mentioned. But basically, the kind of rapid fire range of guns is the ideal zone for a Sisters of Battle army. So if this sounds good to you, and everything else has so far, then chances are you will enjoy playing Sisters of Battle. So, with that in mind, you know, get the codex, have a look through it, that kind of thing, and try and make an army list, okay? As a result of that, you have a good starting place. You know what kind of models you want to be getting, but also it lets you try it out, and you really should try it out. Try out some proxy games. Even if you don't have models, just use some boxes as tanks. Just use some chess pieces as individual models, that kind of thing. Just throw them against random things. Roll some dice. See how they cope in various situations that you can think of. For example, if you look in the back of the 6th edition rulebook, you'll see a table of all the different kind of units in the game and their stat lines and things. Okay, pick ones you think you're likely to face, like normal Space Marines, Terminators, Assault Marines, tanks, that kind of thing. Anything you can think of, okay? Roll some dice against it using your sister's stat lines. See how well they do. If they don't do that well, try something a bit different to help them out. See if they do better. This will really help you finalise a list before you have to buy the models and before you have to test them out, and it'll mean that you'll basically be saving money overall, because you'll be getting the things that are more effective to you. You'll also know if you actually like the playstyle before you try them. And you'll also know how to use them better in your first games. So you'll have a much better chance of success and get the most out of them. Whereas, if you don't do that, then you may take a good unit, apply it badly, and then just dismiss it and never use it again, even though it could be used better, and as a result of that, then you're throwing money away, and that's something you can't really afford to do with Adeptus Sororitas especially. So definitely try that if you can. It doesn't take that much time, you know, it doesn't take long, and you know, you're getting a feel for the army straight off. So after that, then obviously you want some real models, okay? And the basic rule when starting out is this. Okay, try and get battle system models. You can never have too many battle system models. Now, you can get them in many places. Obviously, Games Workshop Direct is the only place to buy them new, which means mail order, and they're very expensive. However, you can also go on eBay, which is the most common place people get them. Doesn't matter if they're painted, because they're metal, so they're quite easy to strip. It takes a bit more effort, but you know, you may be able to get them cheaper. Now I say may, because a lot of the Sisters of Battle units and models often creep up over the original price on eBay, which is a bit ridiculous. People are actually paying more for second-hand models than they would be if they bought them new. I don't think they pay attention to the prices, so make sure you do. Okay, but that also means that sometimes the prices are more or less exactly the same anyway, so you may just want to buy new. My advice is basically ask around your local area, ask around clubs, ask around people who used to play 40k but don't anymore, especially older veterans who have been playing a long time, because generally they build up collections of random models here and there. And when sisters first came out, they were a lot more affordable. And so they may have a bunch of models that they don't want that you can buy cheaply or even get as a gift, that kind of thing, or swaps or whatever. So the most desirable models, I will say straight off, are Meltagons. There's two different Meltagon variants, however, you may get conversions or you may be able to convert some yourself. But basically, any sister with a Meltagon is worthwhile having. You will be using them. The next most desirable one at the moment is Heavy Flamers. Now, this could change in future, but having a bunch of Heavy Flamer options is always nice. You don't need as many as you will Meltaguns, but you know they're still really nice to have. After that, you have Sister Superiors and Flamer models. Fairly obvious. There's a lot of different Sister Superior models with lots of different weaponry. Having a nice mix is a good idea. And of course, after that is the bolter ones. You can, well, you will need lots of girls with bolters. There's also other ones with like the banners, that kind of thing, Simulacrum Imperialis. Get them if you can. Don't go out of your way to get them. You could always make one yourself, that kind of thing. So those are the main ones you want. Everything else is a nice bonus if the price is right. And if it's available to you, I would suggest picking up any kind of sisters model you can. They all hold their value very well. They'll all be useful to you in some way at some time or other. But those are the main ones you'll be looking for. The other things about the vehicles, for example, if you can get Immolator kits instead of Rhinos, there's still a good price on the Games Workshop store. The main reason for this is that you can build them as an Immolator or a Rhino, and because of this, you get lots of extra parts to sisters up your other vehicles and that kind of thing. So, you know, you get more bang for your buck there. The other thing is, if you want an Exorcist, then and you can't get one second hand because they're quite difficult. If you can get one second hand, brilliant. If you can't, then I would suggest buying the Games Workshop Exorcist direct is your best option. Now the reason for this is the Forge World one's more expensive. It doesn't look as nice unless you like the look, of course. Space Marine Whirlwind is only £1 cheaper than the Exorcist, and you'll feel like you got a lot more value for money from the Exorcist kit. Bear in mind though, it's not really for amateur modelers. It's a beast to put together. It's mainly all metal. The huge organ on top is all metal. Basically, everything on top is metal. It's very heavy, but it's very satisfying to build. It's a lot of fun, and of course, it looks amazing when it's all painted up. So, something to look at there. I will say now, if I was you, I'd get one Exorcist if you can. I wouldn't go into more until you're happy with your lists, that kind of thing. Again, you can use proxies, that kind of thing. But I'll go into that more later. So that's pretty much it so far. Make sure you like the playstyle, make sure you like the rules, make sure you like the fluff. Collect miniatures as you can. Basically, just take it slow. Do a little bit at a time. If you can, paint them up as you get them. So paint up what you got, then buy some more, paint up what you got, etc. It's such an expensive army to collect that you want to go slow. And you can be very eager to get going with it, but you could always like use your sisters as an allied force for something else, or even better, you could just proxy other models as part of the sisters, so you're playing straight away. Or you could even just join in on other people's games if you wanted. Like, use your army and just use that part as an allied detachment for someone else and help them out. Something to think about anyway. The last thing I should mention is that with the new codex, priests in particular got very, very good. And although the there's quite a big range of metal models you can get from Games Workshop that are priests, equipping them with the right kind of gear is important. So if I were you, I'd look into making your own priests out of other parts from the Games Workshop range. In particular, collect together things you can use as power mauls, things you can use as plasma guns. They will be useful, but don't stick them together yet. They will help to be magnetized and that kind of thing. So that's all you need to know for now. Okay, and I will be back with a second video soon. We'll go into the tactics and how to pull together an effective list using Sisters of Battle and how to get you winning in your first games. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned later. And the journey ends not cure. And the journey ends not cure. Is not it real? To you.